Hi friends, welcome to KVR Maths Academy. In this video, let's discuss third and fourth problems in exercise 3.3 in polynomials of 10th class mathematics. Right? So before doing these problems, friends, please subscribe my YouTube channel, those who are not subscribed yet. Thank you. Yes, let's go through this. Yeah. See, this is the third question. Find the quadratic polynomial for the zeros alpha beta given in each case 2 minus 1 root 3 and minus root 3 1 by 4 minus 1 1 by 2 3 by 2. Here, find the quadratic polynomial for zeros alpha beta has given. See, here alpha and beta has given. Using this alpha beta, we can find a quadratic polynomial. Right? Do you know what is the quadratic polynomial of zeros alpha comma beta? Yes, k into x square minus alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta. That is the quadratic polynomial, no? So that we have to find using these zeros, which means alpha is equal to 2, beta is equal to minus 1. Right? Yeah. First one, 2 comma minus 1, which means given alpha is equal to 2 and beta is equal to minus 1. Right? Yeah, we know that the quadratic polynomial of zeros alpha and beta is equal to sk into x square minus alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta, where k is a belongs to R, isn't it? Yeah. Now substitute in the place of alpha beta values, x square minus 2 plus beta, here 2 plus beta means plus of minus 1 into x plus 2 into minus 1, isn't it? 2 plus of minus 1 into x plus 2 of minus 1, that is equal to k into x square 2 minus 1, how much actually? 1. Minus of 1, minus 1x means minus x, 1x plus into minus, minus 2. Right? Here k into x square minus x minus 2 has come. If k is equal to, what is the value will you take? If k is k, in the place of k, you may take any value. Here not there any denominator, no? Simply take 1. If k is equal to 1, then required quadratic polynomial is equal to 1 into k is equal to 1 only, na? X square minus x minus 2. So that is equal to finally x square minus x minus 2. So this is the required polynomial of zeros 2 and minus 1. Have you understood clearly? Yes, note it down. So this is the second question. Root 3 and minus 3 has given, which means alpha is equal to root 3 and beta is equal to minus root 3 has given. Right? Yeah. We know that the quadratic polynomial whose zeros alpha and beta is, yes, what is that? K into x square minus alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta, where k is belongs to R, isn't it? Yeah. In the place of alpha and beta, substitute these values. Alpha is equal to root 3 and beta is equal to minus root 3. So that is equal to k into x square minus root 3 plus minus root 3 into x plus root 3 into minus root 3, right? Yeah. So that is equal to k into x square. Here plus root 3 minus root 3 get cancelled. This will be 0 minus 0x. Here plus into minus minus root 3 whole square, right? Root 3 whole square, isn't it? So that is equal to k into x square, this will be 0, na? minus root 3 whole square means minus 3. So this is k into x square minus 3. Now in the place of k, let us take any value. Here, not there any denominator. Not there any denominator, no? In the place of k, let us take 1. Simply enough. If k is equal to 1, then the required quadratic polynomial. Quadratic polynomial is equal to 1 into x square minus 3. So this is simply x square minus 3. So this is the required quadratic polynomial of zeros root 3 and minus root 3. Have you understood clearly? Yes, note it down. Next one, 1 by 4 comma minus 1 has given. Here 1 by 4 means, which means alpha is equal to 1 by 4 and beta is equal to minus 1, right? Yeah. We know that the quadratic polynomial whose zeros alpha and beta is what is that? K into x square minus alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta, where k belongs to R. Isn't it? Yeah. In the place of alpha and beta, substitute these values. So that is equal to k into x square minus, here alpha means 1 by 4. Beta, this is directly write down minus 1 x plus 1 by 4 into minus 1. Isn't it? Yeah. So that is equal to k into x square 3. See, 4 ones are 4. 1 minus 4 is minus 3. Minus 3 into minus. Yes, plus. Plus 3 by 4x. Here plus into minus is, yes, minus 1 by 4. Alright, here denominator 4 is there. Then what we have to take in the place of k, let us take 4. Right. Yeah. Now take, if k is equal to 4, then the required quadratic polynomial is equal to, means k 4 only now, 4 into x square plus 3 by 4x minus 1 by 4. If you multiply it, this will become as 4x square plus 3x minus 1. So this is the required quadratic polynomial of zeros 1 by 4 and minus 1. Have you understood clearly? Yes, note it down. So final one in this third question, 1 by 2 and 3 by 2. Here, alpha is equal to 1 by 2 has given and beta is equal to 3 by 2 has given, right? Yeah. Now, we know that the quadratic polynomial whose zeros alpha and beta is, what is that? Yes, exactly, k into x square minus alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta, right? Yeah. So that is equal to k into x square minus, in the place of alpha and beta, substitute these values, into 1 by 2 plus 3 by 2 into x plus 1 by 2 into, yeah, 3 by 2, right? That is equal to k into x square minus, here 1 by 2 plus 3 by 2 is half plus 1 and half. How much? Yes, exactly 2. So shall I write again this one also? 1 plus 3 by 2 x plus 1, 3 is a 3 by 4. Right. So this one I'll write here, k into x square minus 3, 1 plus 3, 4. 4 by 2 means, yes, 2x. 2x plus 3 by 4. Here denominator is 4. So that's why let us take k in the k value is 4, right? We may take any value here, take 4. Why? Because here denominator is 4, it should be cancelled. So if k is equal to 4, then the required quadratic polynomial is, see, 4 into x square minus 2x plus 3 by 4. So multiply it, 4 into x square, 4x square minus 4 2 is 8x plus here 4 get cancelled, 3. So this is the required quadratic polynomial of zeros 1 by 2 and 3 by 2. Have you understood clearly? Yes, note it down. Okay, this is the fourth question and final question in the exercise 3.3. Yes, verify that 1, minus 1 and minus 3 are the zeros of the cubic polynomial x cube plus 3x square minus x minus 3, and check the relationship between zeros and the coefficients. Right, so come again. Verify that 1, minus 1 and minus 3 are the zeros of the cubic polynomial x cube plus 3x square minus x minus 3, and check the relationship between zeros and the coefficients. Right? Yeah. First, let us verify these are the 1, minus 1 and minus 3 are the zeros of the given polynomial. Right? Yeah. See, solution. Let us take P of x is equal to given polynomial. P of x is equal to x cube plus 3x square minus x minus 3, right? Yeah, let us check 1, minus 1 and minus 3 are the zeros of the polynomial or not, right? So first, take P of 1 is equal to is 1 cube plus 3 into 1 square minus 1 minus 3, right? So this is 1 plus 3 into 1 square into 3 minus 1 minus 3. Here plus 1 minus 1 plus 3 minus 3 get cancelled. So P of 1 is equal to 0 has come. P of 1 is equal to 0. So that's why 1 is the zero of the polynomial of zero value of the polynomial of given polynomial. Right? Next, again P of minus 1 take. So minus 1 whole cube plus 3 into minus 1 whole square minus minus 1 minus 3. Here minus 1 whole cube means minus 1 only, plus minus 1 whole square is 1. 1 3 is a 3. Minus into minus plus 1 minus 3. Here minus 1 plus 1 plus 3 minus 3 get cancelled. Again 0 has come. So P of minus 1 is equal to also 0. Then minus 1 is a 0 of the polynomial of given polynomial P of x. Right. Next, P of another one, minus 3 has given. Minus 3 whole cube plus 3 into minus 3 whole square minus half minus 3 minus 3. Yeah, minus 3 whole cube means, yeah, 3 cube is 27, minus cube means minus 27 only. Next, minus 3 whole square means plus 9. 9 3 is a 27. Minus into minus plus 3, here minus 3. Minus 27 plus 27 get cancelled, 3 minus 3 get cancelled, this is also equal to 0. So here minus 3 is also zero value of given polynomial P of x, right? Therefore 1 minus 1 and minus 3 are the zeros of the given polynomial P of x. Okay, now let us check the relationship between zeros and coefficients of the given polynomial, right? Yeah, look here. So actually, suppose ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d is a cubic polynomial, then its sum of the zeros alpha plus beta plus gamma is equal to what actually? Yeah, minus b by a, right? Next, alpha beta plus beta gamma plus gamma alpha is equal to, yes, exactly, C by A, right? C by A. Next, alpha beta gamma, product of the zeros, alpha beta gamma is equal to minus D by A. Isn't it? So, here we are, AX plus BX square plus CX plus D. If the cubic polynomial, then alpha plus beta plus gamma is equal to minus B by A. So, this is minus x square coefficient by x coefficient, x cube coefficient. Next, alpha beta plus beta gamma plus gamma alpha is equal to C by A. Here, x coefficient by x cube coefficient. Next, alpha beta gamma is equal to minus D by A means minus constant by x cube constant. Already we have discussed in the concept video. Right, so let us check the relationship between the zeros and the coefficient. Right, now take here P of x is equal to, P of x is equal to x cube plus 3x square minus x minus 3. This is in the form of ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d, right? So here a is equal to 1, right? Next, b is equal to 3, c is equal to minus 1, and d is also equal to, is equal to minus. Next, here see, zero, these are the zeros, no? Let us take alpha is equal to 1, beta is equal to minus 1, and gamma is equal to minus 3. Right? Yeah. Now, sum of the zeros, alpha plus beta plus gamma is equal to, alpha plus beta plus gamma, 1 plus minus 1 plus minus 3. That is how much? 1 minus 1 minus 3. Yes, how much? 1 minus 1 get cancelled, minus 3. Okay, actually alpha plus beta plus gamma is equal to what? Minus B by A. Here, minus B by A, no? Here, B by A means minus B by A, minus, that is equal to minus B by A, minus 3 by A is 1. So, that is equal to minus 3. So, both are equal or not? Therefore, alpha plus beta plus gamma is equal to minus B by A. Therefore, alpha plus beta plus gamma is equal to minus B by A. It has completed, right? Next term. Alpha beta plus beta gamma plus gamma alpha is equal to, see, alpha beta, 1 into minus 1 plus minus 1 into minus 3 plus minus 3 into 1. That is 1 1's are minus 1, minus into minus plus 3, minus 3. Minus 3 plus 3 get cancelled, answer is minus 1. So actually alpha beta plus beta gamma plus gamma alpha is equal to what? C by A, right? C by A, this is. Actually, C is here. C is minus 1 by A is 1. So, minus 1 by 1 is minus 1 only. So, here, these both are equal or not? Therefore, alpha beta plus beta gamma plus gamma alpha is equal to how much? Yes, C by A. We have got, right? Yeah, next third one is alpha beta gamma. Alpha beta gamma is equal to, yes, 1 into minus 1 into minus 3. So this is how much? 1 into minus 1 minus 1 into minus 3 plus 3. Right? Here alpha beta gamma is equal to minus D by A. So that is equal to minus. Minus D means here minus. D means minus 3. Minus 3 by A means 1. That is equal to plus 3. Both are equal or not? Therefore, alpha beta gamma is equal to minus D by A. So, this is the relationship between zeros and coefficients of the given polynomial. Have you understood clearly? Yes, note it down. Okay, friends, if you like my video, please like and share. Don't forget to subscribe. Thank you. Thank you very much.